Michael Hernandez of MLH Media and Valley Fight News, and I'm here today at SparStar MMA 54 with a very special guest and Paragon BJJ's Tabatha Ricci. How are you doing today?
I'm doing awesome. Thank you guys for having me here tonight.
Yes, it's always awesome getting to have the pro stars come and watch these amateurs and get to showcase some of their skills. But you came to watch a couple of your teammates, Christian. You also had, Nick, and then you also have your one of Riley. Riley performed earlier, got that unanimous decision victory. How is it feeling to get to watch teammates that you go and grapple against every single day finally get their wins over in the cage?
I'm very happy to be part of their process. You know, I see them in the gym grinding every day, and I'm here to support them. I also want to see them all the way up. So, yeah, I'm very happy to be here and support my teammates. I think this is big motivating for them, too. And we are a team. We got to support our teammates, and we all can elevate together.
Yes, I'm pretty sure it's very motivating having the UFC superstar in this UFC superstar in the house and Baby Shark. You know, I know that they're pretty excited to see you once you were on the sidelines, and even Riley went up to you right after and was like, "Oh, you know, very excited." So, you know, you have a fight coming up on June 24th against Robertson. How are you feeling about this fight? Is it something that has been on your mind a lot lately, or has it kind of been a calmer fight camp for you?
Well, I treat every fight as a different fight, you know. I've been working for a long time. Feel like I'm always ready to get any fight. So I'm feeling very confident, and I think it's going to be a great fight. She's a tough opponent. Respect her, and can't wait to get in the cage.
Yes, you have a very great grappling style, and she loves to throw and swing and bang. So what's kind of your predictions for the match? Are you expecting it to go on the ground, or are you wanting to stand and bang and show some of those baby shark teeth?
Well, I'm going to be ready for anything, but the fight goes, you know. If the fight's been stand up, I'm ready for it. If we're going to bring to the ground, we're going to do some jiu-jitsu, whatever.
Yeah, we know you're definitely very good on the ground with jiu-jitsu. You got your teammates over at Paragon, and then you also train over at Black House, correct? Black House MMA? Mm-hmm. So how is it training back and forth between two gyms? Because as a fighter, I know it's very difficult finding the time, you know, having to make that schedule. What would you say is the biggest piece of advice for other fighters coming up, making that balance, making that schedule of having to go from gym to gym? And then obviously you're very active on the social scenes. You have a very good following. So what's kind of your advice to these fighters are young and up and coming?
Well, I do training at a lot of gyms. Actually, I'm also Black House, Saxons, Knuckleheads in my hometown. I have my wrestling team. So I think you always got to look what is best for you. You know, like if you're starting or if you're an athlete, you're always going to go for it and look for partners, good coaches that is going to help you to elevate. Yeah, so I'm very happy to have the team that I have, the team that I build, and I'm very just grateful for what I have right now.
Yes, it's definitely all about supporting your teammates, and you are here doing that. I'm going to let you go here because Nick Jaramillo is about to go and get in that octagon, but Michael Hernandez of MLH Media and Valley Fight News, and we're going to be signing out with Tabatha Ricci.